Sporting Journal Radio, presented by Onyx.
And I want to get your opinions on how waterfowling has changed. Because when you look back in the 70s and 80s and even the 90s, and even when I grew up, when I first started duck hunting and goose hunting, a lot of it was pass shooting. Mm-hmm. You don't see that as much anymore. A lot of the public grounds, like say Lac Parle, that had the state blinds, you don't see people lining up to go pass shoot one goose as it flies over anymore. Mm-hmm. You see people setting up decoy spreads and, you know, leasing land, and sometimes access is getting more and more limited. Is that becoming a bigger factor in a reduction in license sales, or is that just another contributing factor?
Well, I sure don't think so in Minnesota, Brett. I mean, we've got outstanding access in Minnesota. You know, we've got, you know, we say 10,000 lakes, whatever that means, but we've got 3,000 public accesses on lakes. And, you know, for hunting, you know, it's not the small prairie pothole that is the place where you go to hunt ducks. You go to the bigger lakes, the Swan Lakes, John mentioned, Heron Lake, Marsh Lake, you know, those big lakes that all have public accesses, and you can get on them and you can hunt. And we've got just unfettered, and you think of the 12 million acres of public land that we've got. If you want to walk into a beaver dam, you can. You know, up north, you can shoot that and get into a wild rice lake. There's tons of wild rice lakes up north. Hunt on rivers. I mean, there's just an abundance of places to hunt. I think, at least on the Minnesota side, it'd be different in Texas. It's probably different in North Dakota. But I think on the Minnesota side, I don't think access is really the problem at all.
You don't see those water hunters as much in North Dakota.
No, but I think, you know, the point you make there is that that kind of hunting is expensive.
Yeah.
You know, you got to have a boat. I remember the first time my buddies and I had a boat. It was a little plywood thing. It was an absolute casket, water casket is what it was. But we went out in it and we, you know, paddled across a small slough on it. But, you know, if you're going to, you know, unfortunately, we sort of foster this belief that, well, you got to have the big boat, you got to have the motor on it, you got to have, you know, 3 dozen, you know, full body decoys with, you know, the fanciest Texas rig on them, and you got to have, you know, a $3,000 Benelli shotgun, you got to have 2 good dogs that, you know, compete in trials. And, you know, we create this notion that in order to be a real duck hunter, you got to have these things. And, you know, the first time I shot a duck, I think I was walking through the woods and a wood duck got up out of a pond and I shot it. You know, it does not have to be that complicated. And that's, I think, one of the messages we got to convey to people, is it does not have to be that complicated. And you can get out with a pair of hip boots and a shotgun and a couple of decoys and shoot ducks.
Hear more at sportingjournalradio.com or wherever you get podcasts.